SAP Flexible Workflow is the new way of approving transactional documents in SAP S/4HANA. It is easy to configure and no development is necessary, so let's dive in. But first, let us introduce ourselves. My name is Jazwin Mohammed.
And I am Nick Hurkmans. And we are the most flexible SAP S/4HANA consultants at McCoy.
And to show you how flexible we are, we've added a flexibility counter. Today, we're going to talk about how SAP Flexible Workflow can help you streamline your business processes and increase efficiency. We explain what a flexible workflow is and what documents it can be used on, and what the prerequisites are. After that, we're going to show you how to configure a flexible workflow and show you how it works with an example. So, SAP Flexible Workflow is a functionality in SAP S/4HANA designed to automate and streamline your business processes. By using the flexible workflow, transactional documents like, for example, purchase orders can be sent for approval based on business requirements. The main benefit that flexible workflows offer towards the old business workflow in SAP ECC is that it can be configured without the necessary ABAP development. So anyone can adjust existing or create new workflows without the need for a developer. Other advantages are that the approvals are presented by default in the My Inbox app for the end users, and standard email functionality is available for notifications. On top of all the standard functionality, it does offer a range of extensibility options like custom agent determination and custom workflow conditions. Flexible workflows can be used on a wide range of documents, including purchase orders, invoices, and legal transactions. This means that you can streamline the entire process from document creation to approval, saving time and increasing efficiency. Would you like to learn more about SAP S/4HANA capabilities? Please check out our very own playlist in the description that includes lots of information about new features, like for example, output management and situation handling.
There are a few prerequisites before you're able to use and leverage the flexible workflow functionality in SAP. At first, the recipients of your workflow tasks are to be maintained as employees in your system. Additionally, these employees are to be set up as a business partner in S/4HANA. Generic flexible workflow activation and setup is to be done. SAP provides documentation on how to configure flexible workflows on the SAP Help Portal. At last, the required roles for authorization are to be assigned to the respective users. You, as the configurator of the flexible workflows, need access to the Fiori apps for managing flexible workflows. And additionally, the recipients need access to the My Inbox app to approve or reject the workflow tasks. Up next, we will demonstrate how to build a flexible workflow and how to leverage it. In this example, we will configure a workflow for purchase requisition approval. SAP contains several apps which are specifically built for building your flexible workflows, such as the Manage Workflows for Purchase Requisition apps. The app contains multiple workflow scenarios which are listed in here. And each workflow scenario has its own status, validity, and you can order these scenarios. For now, we're going to build a new workflow scenario. Each workflow scenario has its own start conditions and one or multiple approval steps. Of course, you can also update the name, the description, and as mentioned, the validity of your workflow scenario. If you focus on the start conditions, the app contains multiple pre-configured start conditions. For instance, the workflow should be started based on a certain account assignment category, for instance, purchasing group or purchasing organization or a certain net amount. For now, I want to configure my workflow in such a way that if an account assignment category cost center is assigned, my workflow starts. When focusing on these steps, each step also has its own start conditions, recipients, and can be constrained by deadlines. Several pre-configured recipients are in this app, which can be found here. So there are several roles such as the account accounting object responsible, which is the cost center owner, which will be the approver of my workflow step. You can also specify certain users which should approve or reject your workflow step by selecting the user assigned. And here you can specify a user ID. After building your workflow scenario, obviously don't forget to save. And after saving your workflow scenario, you can activate and specify the order of your workflow steps. After activating the new flexible workflow for purchase requisition approval, I want to use it. In this fictional example, a user created a purchase requisition item that meets the start conditions of my newly created workflow. I'm now logged in as the cost center owner, and I can approve or reject the purchase requisition approval. The My Inbox app can be used for all the approval tasks. An approval tasks contain information about the purchase requisition, which can be found here. And in the bottom, I can approve or reject the approval task. For now, I'm going to approve. And after my approval, the purchase requisition is released. Today, we talked about flexible workflow and its benefits. Additionally, we discussed examples of business scenarios in which you can leverage it. And at last, the prerequisites of flexible workflow were listed. We finished this video in an SAP system with a demo on how to build and use flexible workflow. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out our playlist.